Hey gang, what's going on? First off, I want to tell you that I am utterly exhausted. It's been a rough day, and coming home and having to move the entirety of my basement around for who knows when surprise furniture is going to get here. If you're not following me on Twitter, then you don't know the story of, hey, surprise furniture should be here in the next few days. Surprise! Anyway, when I got home today, this little box was sitting in my door, and it is from this thing called Fun Publications. So I'm going to go ahead and open this box. And I believe it says Depth Charge on it in stickers. See? Depth Charge. Depth Charge. So we are going to get a quick unboxing here. And then I'm going to attempt to make some room for myself in the basement. Yes, yes indeedy, that is a Depth Charge. Straight out of the box, Depth Charge is a fantastic looking futuristic plane, kind of a Yukikaze look. I absolutely adore this alt mode, and this is one of my favorite figures from the after movie, I believe, Reveal the Shield, I don't remember, or Hunt for the Decepticons, or Hunt for the Over-Exuberant Donut. I don't know. I'm sorry, guys. I am really tired. But this figure looks just so stunningly nice. The powder blue and the purple and the yellow and the gray just work absolutely wonderfully together. You'll notice that the front of the figure is kind of looks like some kind of animal. And I could see this easily being stretched out and expanded into a manta ray. But here, kind of looks like a shark, if I'm honest. Looks really neat. I love the color scheme on this guy. I really do. And I really don't want to keep harping and praising on it. But it is a very striking and nice looking figure. And you could see the cockpit easily here. And you could see that in the original figure. And I'm sure you could see that in the Machine Wars Starscream figure that Botcon was released. Sorry. Words failing. Landing gears are exactly like the original figure. Easily fold upable. And you can store the weapon, trident, in vehicle mode. Very easily as well. I'm not going to do it here. I'm just going to leave it off to the side. Again, a very nice vehicle mode, and I'm really glad I got this guy instead of, say, picking up the Botcon Machine Wars Starscream. I really think the brighter colors work better for this mold for some reason. The weapon is exactly the same as the original figure, this nice folded-up trident. And you just transform it the same way. Fold out the staff bit, take the trident bit, and push it down until the forks extend. Now, the one thing I have noticed is the trident pieces don't really stick out as far. The trident forks don't stick out as far, so it kind of looks like a three-pronged pitchfork as opposed to a trident. And this yellow piece is made of somewhat thin plastic, but you really can't get around that. And you do get bleed or color bleed from the inside of the piece as it's sticking onto the shaft. But otherwise, it's a very nice little weapon, if not perfect, but oh well. I still like it, though. The transformation for this figure is exactly the same as anyone else that was made in this mold. Space Case, Terra Dive, Starscream, Bill and Ted. Okay, not Bill and Ted. We'll reach under the bottom and unpeg the legs. That will disconnect the wings from the body. Then we can fold the legs forward and then take the front of the canopy and turn that 180 degrees. Then take these bits here and fold them up. Once you rotate the section around the fuselage, we have to flip this bottom part up. And this is probably the hardest part of the transformation, at least for me. And then take this little blue piece and kind of push that out. When we do that, we can then take the entire front section and pull it forward along the nose cone, and then flip this whole front section up and then push it up to lock it into place. And then take those folded bits, flaps here, and fold them up, and that will form the chest. And when we do that, as you saw, what I forgot to do is actually get it in line here so that when you swing the legs down, or these bits here, you swing them down and get them to sit, or to have the nose cone bit that you just folded up sit right on top of the legs, like that. And then we could just get in here and fold out the feet. Get them all folded out, okay. Okay, so here we have the way the wing should be positioned on the foot, or on the leg. So what we're going to do is just pull the wing all the way out, and then turn the wing such that this bigger peg is pointing down towards the heel and pegs in just above my thumb. And then fold that down, and that will peg into the leg, and then the wing will peg into another peg and sit comfortably on the side of the leg. The last bits of the transformation are, first, take the engines here and fold them, push them in to the inside of the vehicle, and they will flip around, and then these will become the arms. So we'll flip them out, and we'll deal with them in a minute. Then take this yellow piece and flip it up, and that will allow us to then take the head area, fold that whole section back, flip the head down, and then take this whole bottom part and flip it up and around to form the arms. And then the arms, or these sections that were part of the engine, will then fold in and peg into place, along with the back pegging into place. And this is probably the trickiest part of the transformation, which is just getting everything lined up correctly. And I'm probably not doing a good job of this for you guys, but to be honest, I'm so tired. I really am making mistakes. Sorry, I know that's not much of an excuse, but... Now, I will be the first to admit that I did not think this was going to be all that great. I honestly didn't. And I'm blown away. I'm really surprised here, guys. I'm genuinely surprised because I really like this guy. I love the paint scheme. I love the overall look. The head sculpt works. It's just a really nice interpretation of a classic Beast Wars character. Poseability is exactly the same as the figure. Head or ball joint on the head, swivel in the shoulders, and then a hinge just after that. Swivel underneath that with a double elbow for lots of articulation, and then a swivel at the fist. Hips are on the ball joints there with swivels just underneath. Knees on some nice bendy hinges. No real foot articulation except for what would be part of the transformation. Overall, just a solid figure. Just really nice. Love the maximal symbol right there on the chest. And the overall look of the figure is really cool. I dig the color schemes for this guy. It works. It really does. Now, Depth Charge always had a very strange head sculpt, and that has continued over here, but it's evolved a little bit. Though I have to admit, it looks more like a He-Man villain than anything else. I will call you Snorkler. He does have some really nice light piping going on, though. If I had anything negative to say about this figure, I would just have to say that I find the head sculpt to be a little on the odd side. It's not bad by any means, and in fact, I quite like it. It is just a little bit weird. The only other negative I can come up with is something that's in the directions, and that's the fact that Space Case is in the directions in robot mode, and not Depth Charge. Just very weird. In my humble opinion, I think Funpub is actually bounding 1,000 right now. Scourge is a really nice figure. Depth Charge is, again, a really nice figure. Both of these guys are pretty darn cool. Are they repaints? Yeah, pretty much. But I like them. I dig them. I think they're really cool. I'm glad I got them, and so far I'm happy with my $350 spent on these subscription figures. So, yeah, Funpub, keep going. I'm digging these. one more. So guys, hope you enjoyed this look at a depth charge here, and I'll catch you next time. Hopefully, a little less tired.